number 10 mistake that new Amazon sellers make is they run out of stock. A lot of times, new Amazon sellers will run out of stock and then their product completely disappears from the search rank and they just undo all of the work that they've been working on. Make sure if you're selling on Amazon that you plan your inventory correctly and you don't run out of stock.
So the ninth big mistake is they only plan on running sponsored products to get traffic. They have no other way to get people to come to their listings. And honestly, in today's market, that's not enough. You have to have other strategies to get traffic to your Amazon listings besides sponsored products.
The eighth big mistake is they do not have a strategy to get reviews for their products. And that's extremely important because when you first begin, you have zero reviews and the chances of somebody trying your product with no reviews are very, very low. So you have to have a way to generate reviews. We'll have some links in the description below on how you can generate reviews. There's some resources for that. The seventh mistake is they charge too much for their product when they're first launching. Of course, you gotta make margin, but in the beginning, it's not about making margin. It's not even about making a profit. It is okay to lose money. What you're trying to do in the beginning is get reviews and get sales velocity. So in the beginning, sometimes you need to lower your price and you're probably even losing money. You're not making very much profit. Don't worry about that. That's just trying to get the flywheel moving and start making those sales. So don't charge too much for your product when you first launch. So the sixth big mistake is they send too much inventory to Amazon. They make this big order of 1,000 or 2,000 units and they don't have a place to store it, so they ship it all straight to Amazon FBA. It doesn't sell right away, and then they get hit with a ton of storage fees and long-term storage fees and all this stuff. And instead, what you should do is send your product to a third-party warehouse or to your own storage facility and then ship in just enough to sell to FBA. The fifth big mistake is they don't optimize their product for FBA. What I mean by that is there's certain tweaks you can do in your packaging, in your weight, that you can save money in your FBA fees. It can be a huge difference between having a really profitable product and not having a profitable product at all. So the fourth big mistake is they don't invest in product videos. Product videos are a really easy way to set yourself apart from the competition. You can run product video ads, you can have product videos on your detail page. There's so many ways to use product videos. If you're not using product videos, you definitely need to be using product videos. Third mistake is not investing in good product photography. Your product photography is so important. It's way more than the text. So if you're not investing in good product photography, you're really missing out. Do not sell yourself short and make sure that you spend money on product photography. The second mistake that a lot of Amazon sellers make is they avoid registering their brand with brand registry right away. They don't want to spend the money in investing in the trademark or anything like that. And that's honestly a huge mistake, really for a couple of different reasons. The first reason is you don't have any protection for your brand. Anybody can sell on your listing. It's also easier just to sell a product if you have brand registry, but then also Amazon gives you all kinds of extra features like Amazon Vine and a bunch of other really cool things like doing videos on your products and stuff like that. So you should definitely go ahead if you're serious about launching a brand on Amazon and just pay for brand registry. And the first mistake is they do not have a product with a unique selling proposition. And what I mean by that is that they're trying to sell the same thing that everybody else is selling for the same price. There's nothing unique about the product whatsoever. So they go on to whatever tool they use to figure out sales. They see that water bottles are selling really well. They're making $100,000 a month. And they're like, I'm gonna sell that product too. They go source it on Alibaba. There's nothing unique about it. Nothing setting themselves apart from the other people that are selling this product that already have 20,000 reviews. So that is the number one mistake that most Amazon sellers make when they're new.